Hello and welcome to Chips and Tricks. Having trouble making blind hole threads? In today's episode, you'll find 4 helpful tips to help you solve your problems. Let's take a look at what a blind hole actually is. In contrast to a through hole, the tab does not fully penetrate the workpiece in a blind hole. The thread is therefore not cut through to the end. In addition, the chips are transported upwards out of the hole in the opposite direction to the feed direction. This is made possible by a positive helix angle. But what do you need to look out for with blind hole threads? First of all, the pre-drill diameter. If the pre-drill diameter is too small, the threading tool has to cut more material, which results in a poor service life or even tool breakage. If the pre-drill diameter is too large, the thread is not cut correctly. The flanks are not formed correctly, causing the thread to lose its bearing capacity, so it fails to meet the standard. As a general rule of thumb for the correct pre-drill diameter, remember, nominal thread diameter minus the pitch. Second of all, the wrong thread depth is programmed. If the tab is inserted too deeply into the hole, the tool and workpiece will collide. The result? A broken tool. You can easily avoid this mistake by checking the length of the tab in advance, programming the thread depth correctly, or making the core hole a little deeper. Third of all, the clearance angle is too large. A large clearance angle has the advantage that the tab cuts well. However, the greater the clearance angle, the greater the risk that the chip will jam when turned back and the tool will break off. Or it could cause the tool to lose control, which has a negative effect on the accuracy of the gauge. You can significantly minimize this risk by choosing the right tab. The Gehring Navigator can help you with this. In contrast to a through hole, you should do without Form B in a blind hole. In this case, the chips are pressed against the bottom of the blind hole. Instead, you should use a spiral tab for blind holes. Due to the smaller clearance angle, the chip can not only share better when the direction of rotation changes, the chips are also transported out of the bore at the top. Fourthly, the tab is not suitable for the material. For long chipping materials, we recommend spiral tabs. The positive twist angle here is ideal for pushing the chips upwards out of the tool. For short chipping materials, such as cast iron, it is better to opt for a straight fluted tab. Here, the short chips are rinsed out by the coolant. Now you know what matters when it comes to blind holes. Our chip tip for today, all good things come in fours. In the case of blind hole threads, it is essential to pay attention to the pre-drill diameter, the drilling depth, the clearance angle, and the right tab. Now nothing stands in the way of your perfect blind hole thread. In the next episode of Chips and Tricks, I will explain what you can do if your threads are too big in blind holes. Tune in!